Hello friends, in this video we shall see the process of creating a Java application in the NetBeans IDE. So as you start your NetBeans software, choose the new option from the file menu. The new option will give you a sort of a filter or the different project categories which are available to you, out of which you choose the Java, and as soon as you choose Java, the right hand column will show you the list of applications under the Java filter or Java category, out of which you choose the Java application. Okay. So press on next. It is basically a wizard based activity. So the second step in the wizard will ask you the project name, project location and project folder. Most of the times the NetBeans itself will suggest you the locations, project name of course you have to give, the location and the folder will be suggested by NetBeans. If you want to, you can override that and give whichever location or whichever folder name you want to. Okay. Then you have to specify the main class. You see, your Java application will contain one or more than one Java classes. At least one Java class will be there. Okay, and the class in which main method is defined. Any number of Java classes may be there, but the program or the application will have only one entry point, and that entry point is the main method. So which is the class that will, that you want the main method to be defined? That you specify the main class. Okay. And as you complete the wizard activity, the class that you specified as the main class, the Java file, whatever main class, main.java, will be opened in the editor. It will create a sort of a skeleton of the program, the name of the public class main, and under which public static void main, that skeleton will be created. You will have to enter the code, whichever programming logic you may have thought of, that you will put into the main method, right? This being a Java class, you may have to define the instance variables, the members and the methods that are required in your class. That is the next step. If at all you want, if your program requires more than one classes, you can always click on the source folder, right click and add new. New will give you a list out of which you choose the classes. Okay, you may want certain interfaces or some other Java class types that may be needed. You can add by clicking add new. Okay. After your coding part is over, more than one classes, one or more than one classes that are required, after you have actually coded that, you have to compile and build. You can use either the toolbar, the triangle button is for run, and there is a compile button also. You can either use that, or you can choose the name of the project, right click, in which there will be a compile and build options, compile, build and run. Those options will be there. From the toolbar also you can do, from the context menu also you can do. Okay. While the project is compiled, after the compilation is over, a dist folder is also created. You can view, or you can see this dist folder in the files view of your project. Okay. And in this dist folder, there will be one jar file. Jar stands for Java archive file, which can be used for distribution of your project. It will be a sort of a self executable file. That jar file can be used as a distribution. Okay. So this is the sequence of events or sequence of steps that you must follow while creating a simple Java application. What I will do now is to show you using NetBeans IDE to actually create a Java application, perform the compilation, run it, and also have a look at the jar file so that it can be distributed. So all that activity I will now show you with the help of a demonstration in front of you.
This demonstration shows you how to create a standard Java SE application using the NetBeans IDE. So start a new project, choose the Java category and in which the type of project is Java application. Choose a proper name to your project. Let us say I want to create a project which will calculate the area of a rectangle. So I am just giving a name as rectangle. Okay. Then the project location is by default, it will be a folder in the NetBeans folder inside the My Documents. If you want, you can change it. Okay. And create the main class rectangle.rectangle is by default the name of the Java class file that will be created. If you want again, you can change it. So the project specifications are over. This is the structure of the SE project that will be created. We have seen that the projects window shows the logical structure of the program in which a rectangle package with the name rectangle is created and in which by default the rectangle.java is created. The skeleton of the rectangle.java is also created here. Now the actual program goes into this. Because I want to calculate the area of rectangle, I will just simply declare these three instances, rather the variables, and then I will assign some values. Then calculate the A for area. And then I'll just give an output statement. That's it. So this is a very simple program. Next step is to build the project. The build result will be shown here. Build is successful. It is also showing me where the distribution jar file is created. It is created in the dist directory of the, you know, this project. That you can see in the files window. If I expand on this, there will be a dist folder and then there is a rectangle.jar. So if you run this, the output to be displayed in the output window is area is equal to 200. Okay, so this is a simplest possible Java SE project demonstration in NetBeans IDE. Next, if I want to provide the command line arguments to this Java project, so that if the program is run from the command line, how the arguments can be used in the main function of your program. So for that, for the, you can say the emulation of the command line arguments, what you have to do is go in the rectangle projects, projects properties, then in the run node, these are the arguments. So here you can specify the value of the values of the length and breadth. Let us say if I say 30 and 20, these values or these are the arguments that I want to pass to the main method in your rectangle.java. Okay. Now instead of hard coding n is equal to 20 and b is equal to 10, what I will do, I will say use the command line argument number 1, that is args0. And similarly B also equal to args1. Okay, so whatever the values the command line passes to this main, they will be used up and the calculation will be done. So we'll recompile that, rebuild. And run. So what happens? The command line argument that we have given will be provided to LNB, the multiplication will be given. That's it. If you want to change that, again go in the properties, change the values in the argument section of the run window. If you actually run this from command line, you may have to provide those values from the command line itself. Okay, so this is another addition to the demonstration of creation of Java SE project using the NetBeans. First we have seen a simple project or the mechanism of creating a NetBeans project, and then we have added the functionality of command line arguments. By giving the command line arguments in the run node of the project properties, we have sort of emulated the command line execution, right? If you actually want to execute the program from the command line, you have to go into the dist folder of the project. Name of the project is our rectangle, inside which there is a dist folder, and inside which there is this rectangle.jar file. So open a command line or command prompt into the dist folder and then give a command line like this: Java dash jar rectangle.jar, and follow it by the command line argument that you wish to give. Okay, just press enter. Those values 11 and 22 will be provided or passed on to the main function. They will be stored in the args array. Args 0 and args 1 will become l and v. They are parsed into l and v integers, and the multiplication will be done. You will get the result as area equal to 24. That's how the actual command line execution will take place. But before actual execution, you can sort of test it from the NetBeans IDE like I have shown you.